All right, welcome to the final installment of my Sweet Pick Challenge. So I'm just going to jump right into this and then talk about how I feel about my progress afterwards. But what I'm going to do while I'm doing these shapes is I'm going to start them slow so that you can see that they're clean, and then I'm going to speed them up, and we'll see if I can keep them clean. So I'm going to start with the just diatonic seventh chords through C major. So here we go. The A position, major and minor shapes. Alright, and here's a D position, major minor. There's that. And then the solo I've been working on, like I said, was the Moonlight solo. So with the tap in there. So here goes that. I can do that better. Hold on. There we go. That was all right. So, anyway, you know, right there I was trying to really push the speed that I had done, so some of that was a little bit sloppy, but I did really increase my speed quite a bit in doing this. I think in when I first started, I was able to do stuff like this clean at about this speed. Right there, which is about half notes at eighth notes at 60. 16th notes at 60, eighth notes at 120. And now I can do 16ths pretty clean, or up around 160. So that's like. So, you know, that's a decent increase, and only in 2 months too. I'm sure that there are a lot of players that are out there that are far more overzealous than I am in their practicing, and will just practice obsessively. Not only because they're just crazy that way, but they have the time, like, I really don't, but, you know, I practice as much as I can. But, you know, some people get really hardcore on this, and I think if somebody got really, like, really into this and just practiced hardcore, like, 5 hours every single day or something like that, they could get really good at this in the 2 months and show a lot better progress than I did. But I think my progress was pretty good, so I think that, judging from the comments that I've gotten, you guys would tend to agree. seems to have inspired a lot of people to really learn to try it. The method that I described in the first video, I've gotten people saying, you know, having it put so plainly and directly and simply makes it a lot easier to learn, and it sort of takes away some of the mystery regarding the technique. But I think it worked, and so I think that the main thing that I would want everyone to take away from this is just realize that sweet picking isn't that hard. It's not this super mysterious, crazy technique that only these just ultra masters can do. Anybody can do it. So go for it. And, you know, if you're going to learn it, though, be creative with it, because that's just a major pitfall of so many people who do it. So don't overuse it. Use it wisely. That's it. Later.